It was a gathering of youth activists in Los Angeles, as 24 chapters of Anakbayan USA converged recently for their third National Congress. The Congress takes place every 3 years, and for this session, about 200 participants focused on the youth's role in speaking up against Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte's so-called abusive policies. And by continuing to raise their voices, they said they know there could be threats to their safety and well-being. Philippine police have recently arrested a group of arts activists who've been accused of spray-painting political messages on public properties. Earlier this summer, the Philippine Justice Department filed charges against 9 activists, including current and former party list lawmakers, for allegedly recruiting minors to join their groups. Last month, Chinese-American activist Brandon Lee returned home to San Francisco after surviving what activists believed to be a politically motivated assassination attempt. Despite these incidents, all of these Anakbayan members vowed to continue mobilizing youth voices.
We as Filipino activists here in the United States have not been exempt from these attacks that Duterte is inciting and directing. We have been called terrorists, we have been doxxed, we have even been physically assaulted by Duterte supporters here. This Congress was our way of saying and declaring that we will not back down and we will continue to fight despite these attacks.
Activists capped off the Congress, which took place at UCLA, with a massive protest and march from MacArthur Park to the Chinese consulate, where they also called for sovereignty from the Chinese government and protested China's territorial claims in the West Philippine Sea.
We are here today to continue our revolutionary tradition and ensuring Duterte's downfall, because when fascists do not listen to the people but to their foreign masters, they must be ousted!
While the march eventually ended at the Philippine consulate, activists said their fight will continue in their respective chapters, including working with U.S. lawmakers to stop USA to the Philippines unless the alleged human rights violations stop. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News.